Hey Capricorn, this is part two. I got a little held up, the school bus came and dropped off the kids from school and everything, so I had to fix them a snack. I made them peanut butter and jelly sandwiches with sliced apples. I skinned the apples. I took the red skin off and the red apples. What they call them, Jonathan apples. I think I got a bag of what it says here. Wait, no. I think they're called Granny Smith apples. Yeah, Granny Smith apples, apple slices, and I gave them a Capri Sun each. Well, the oldest boy, he's bigger, he's older, so I gave him two Capri Suns. I gave the baby boy one Capri Sun. He wanted to have two like his big brother. I said, no, you got to save room for dinner. I'm cooking an awfully good, a big pot of witchy, witchy, witchy stew. And I'm going to give you ladies my recipe of how I do my stew. I use the finest cuts of beef. Of course, I had to catch an Uber when we got home. When the kids got home, I got in the Uber. I listened to the Uber everywhere. That made it go by quicker. And I got the same driver as last time. And he still wouldn't let me get by with the 350. But I guess what I did manage. Today I was looking kind of purty. And so I had on my red lipstick on, because I only got like 3 to 4 nice tops, besides the green dress I'm about to order. And I had on my red lipstick on, like Johnny Gill say, put on that red dress. And them high heels and that sweet perfume. I just wanna look at you. You bumzilla are so fine. I can't believe you're all mine. And I just wanna screw you. I wanna do so many things. Tonight I'm gonna show your crazy ass everything I think of you. I'm gonna set you up. And make you holler, I love him. I wanted you to say, I love him tonight. And I'm so damn fine. I'm sorry, y'all. I just get caught up because, I got such a beautiful voice. I like to imitate others. I know I can't sing, but it just. I don't have no personality of my own. Okay. But I'm gonna finish doing the Capricorn, reading Capricorn. Now I haven't forgot what the first cards I pulled for you was a Hangman upside down, the World card, and we was listening to Bruno Mars, but look, I got something different for you guys. One of my favorite ladies, and I like to pretend and dress up and act like I'm her. And even though I'm getting fatter, I like to act like my body is really nice like hers. Nice perky breasts, flat stomach, nice round ample bottom butt, apple bottom jeans, boots with the fur. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, yeah, I got a little, I'm feeling myself. I think it's from talking to that guy off of Plenty of Fish. Cause honey, let me tell you, ladies, you men, close your ears real quick. I don't think no men listen to me. Ladies. You talking about fish. I just put it like this. The fish was jumping over here today, if you know what I mean. If you know what I mean. Fish was jumping. But it wasn't no catching. But the fishes was jumping. I said, oh, you're going to have to come see me tomorrow. I'm going to let them come by and see me tomorrow. I'm going to cook them a good, some of this leftover witchy, witchy. I call it, it's my own recipe, special recipe. Witchy, witchy, witchy beef stew. I usually cook it during Samhain or Halloween, but we call it Samhain, but that's what we call it, but you all call it Halloween or Hallow's Eve, but last time I made it was during that season, Samhain, when I had all the salamanders on the porch, when I put the pumpkins out, remember that? And the damn salamanders ate the damn pumpkins up, and the flies ate it up, but it really wasn't them, it was because of my demonic ass. Oh, there I go again with them damn kundalini ticks, doing them crazy laughs again. Oh, shit, let me stop. Come on now, get together. Wait, let me get centered into the universe. Plenty of fish. I got me a new boyfriend, hopefully with a big dick. Get out of here. I'm in here doing my mantra. Get out of here. Close my door. I'm so sick of these kids. I don't know what to do with them. Oh, I mean, what I was really saying, I love my kids and I wouldn't know what I would do without them. I didn't mean for you all to hear that. But I got the screen dark once again because of that old flabby chin ass old bitch Donna Martinez. She's always in my damn tea. That bitch need to get a motherfucking life and get some business. I don't even believe she got a husband anymore. Because if she did, I think that man done left her. Because if he was around her, she would not have time to fuck with me like she do. Now, anyway, I'm going to finish doing this reading for Capricorn because somebody ordered a reading last year. It was a little mix-up. And they said that they sent me the money. And, of course, I already spent the money. And they trying to make me think that they paid for a whole hour with the video. I beg to differ. All I saw is they paid for 30 minutes. So I said, well, since I don't have no proof and you don't have a receipt, I'm just going to do it the way I want to do it. I'm going to read it for the whole fucking month, okay? Oh, I mean the whole month. Oh, I hope that my buttercup is not listening because I met him out plenty of years. Yes, I did. Like I said, the catfish are jumping. But first of all, I'm going to set the tone. I did my little mantra. It opened up my third eye chakra and everything so I can get this reading on. But I'm going to put on one of my favorite ladies. Now, she's a true daughter, and I'm not making fun of this deity, Oshun. I lied. I'm going to tell you guys, I lied. I said that, you know, I felt like Oshun was calling me, and Oshun dealt with me on that shit and said, I just put it like this. She straightened me out real good because she doesn't fuck with me. She don't fuck with me. She fucks with me, this lady right here very heavily because she represents her to the T. You know, and she's from Louisiana. And, you know, Donna say that one of her great-great-great-grandmother is supposed to be Marie Laveau. That's a fucking lie. I don't believe that shit. If you believe that, Paul Gouache, you believe it. You'll believe the shit I tell you. You know, I lie all the damn time. I even take your damn money. Won't get you, and you ain't even want to go to take me to small claims court because I'm about to scam you like you motherfuckers. I mean, oh, damn. You know what? That comes from Kundalini, y'all. I'm sorry. I got Tourette syndrome or Kundalini one or the other. I'm sorry. And I just keep cussing and saying the shit that I... Oh, oops. See, there it go. That was a Kundalini tick. Okay, well, let me just put the music on so we can concentrate on something else to get my mind right before I do the rest of this Capricorn reading. Take it away, babe, Queen Bee. Young Shang Yang Yeong Yang Yong. Oh, young say, yeah, 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 yeah. Let me give a fake reading again, because I am a fake tarot card reader. I don't know how to read cards correctly. I am a fake and a phony. Let it come across as real, because I'm a fake bitch and a fake witch. That's what I'm going to say to my boyfriend when he come over here. When my boyfriend from Plenty of Fish come see me, I'm gonna be looking just like her.
Let the partition, please.
Oh, yeah. You don't want to see a partition, please.
I don't need to see,
but I'm still on her knees.
45 minutes to get all dressed up.
It don't take me that long to get dressed up. I don't even wash my ass.
Oh, he's so honey, yeah, he went too far. He popped on my buttons and he ripped my blouse. He's mine, I kind of whiskey all on my gown. Oh, that daddy, daddy didn't bring the towel. Oh, baby, baby, better slow it down. Took 45 minutes to get all dressed down. And we even gonna make it to this club.
Take all of me. I just wanna get the girl you like. Girl you like. The kind of girl you like. Girl you like.
That's right. I want to be the girl you like, Sean from Plenty of Fish, and I'm going to smell like fish, because it don't take me 45 minutes to get ready. I don't wash my ass. Ha, ha, ha. Hey, 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 hey. Y'all kids, get out of here. I'm trying to get my groove on. Get on now. I ain't lost my groove yet. I'm kind of like Stella, baby. So that guy off of Plenty of Fish. I want y'all to hear me. You know, I ain't lost my groove, honey. Don't let nobody tell you 41-year-old women can't get lost their groove, honey. I never lost my groove. I just been doing it by myself. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to let Mr. Sean come over here and knock it out the ballpark. Do you hear me? Can I get a hello? Yeah.
yeah, I heard Donna doing that. I'm just copying off her, old nasty old bitch. That bitch lost her groove. I bet she dry down there in the damn Sahara Desert. I bet it's so motherfucking dry down there. That's why her husband left her. That's why she at home always trying to mimic me all the fucking time. A stupid old bitch. I hate that old bitch. I hate her. I'm gonna do a hate spell on that bitch tonight. I'm gonna do that the horns on her head that I see in meditation, they come out and everybody get to see the horns on her head that she's really a satanic ass succubus bitch. Well, being, I like succubus though, because I'm a bisexual witch though. So I don't know. I think I might be attracted to Donna. You think I should? No, I didn't say that. Oh, I hope they didn't hear me. Okay, back to Beyonce. Cause y'all don't need to see Bumzilla on her knees. Driver, pull out the partition, please. He gonna be rich and fancy and drive a big pretty car. He gonna have a limo. Or did I really talk to somebody named Sean from Plenty of Fish? Or was that last year? Wait, what am I doing anyway? What was I supposed to be doing? Wait a minute. Well, I'll just listen to the music real quick, and maybe it'll help jar my memory, you know? Because I'm feeling kind of freaky right now. I haven't lost my groove yet, baby. I'm like Stella got a groove back. Well, Bumzilla done got her motherfucking groove back. That monkey gave me my groove back, told me I was pretty, and you can't tell me a motherfucking thing, bitch. I got two snaps up, ho. You hear me? You hear me?
Handprints and good looks all on my shirt. Riding the show with the music blasting. She likes to call me peaches when we get this nasty. Red wine drip top that truck.
That's what they call me, peaches, when I get real nasty. When a bunch of guys run me, I get nasty like that. I get real, real fucking nasty. I get so damn nasty, baby. I get nasty. I get nasty, honey. I get so nasty. I just get too fucking nasty, honey. That's why they call me peaches. That damn Donna. But you know what? I'm gonna give y'all reading. Just hold tight, cause it's fake anyway. Shit, I just be making this shit up to get your money. The nigga talking about I owe him some money. Talking about he never got his reading. But I'm whispering. They can't hear me no way, cause I'm a fake ass bitch anyway. I don't do no real readings for nobody, any motherfucking way. So anyway, let's see what the fuck I'm gonna do. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm gonna put on another one. That damn Don probably gonna have his shit fucking flagged the fuck down, or probably a copyright. Even though it be from YouTube, but I really think it's her behind that shit. Really, Donna rules the world. Seriously, Donna is a Mason ass bitch. Don't ever let them tell you that women can't be Mason. She's a Mason ass bitch, I tell you. Just like my youngest son's father. She's a fucking Mason. My young son's father looked like Ron Jeremy off the old school porno movies. But it's like this. He's a Mason and he be tapping into my phone. And I found out that Donna and him kind of know each other. I found out they were half cousins on the Creole side. Donna ain't shit but a Mason out bitch. Her husband's a Mason too. And that's why he ain't at home, because he had the fucking Mason meeting doing all kind of proverbial perverse things. And then sometimes she go and she let all the Masons have her. She walk in with that eyes wide shut open, you know, that movie. And then they killed the director the next day after it was released, because they told too many secrets when they filmed it in the Rothschild castle. Yeah, I know a lot of shit because I'm a witchy bitch. Donna thinks she know more, but she don't know more than me. I know about a lot of shit. But that was the real Rothschild castle. They filmed that movie eyes wide open, white with shut, whatever, with Tom Cruise in it. And it was made at the original damn, a mansion where they have parties like that. And, you know, you'd be naked underneath and you just be freaking and freaking and shit and doing what the hell you want to do with whoever you got a mask on. You know who you fucking, you know, with me. That's how, I mean, the only difference between me and that kind of party is just that I'm going to have a mask on. You remember the mask I wore for Halloween? Donna said that was kind of cute. When Donna gave me compliments, he used to boost my self-esteem. Well, she was really making an ass out of me, but if you notice, I did start looking a little bit better though, didn't I? Because at first I was looking like a lemon frog face bitch. Now I'm looking like, I think I'm looking kind of pretty, but I'm getting real fat now. I'm a big old fat bitch now. You know how fat I'm getting, right? Yeah, I heard the LA over there the other night. Talking about I look like Zoda. What the fuck is that? Shit. Don't nobody want no bone, Donna. She not real fat, but she not real skinny. But for her to be an old bitch, she could stay in the game some weight. Talking about she wears 7 and 8. That's just too entirely small for a woman her age. I'm bragging about her, but she wears size 5 and 6 panties. Now you tell me that she got a real ass back there. She's a, and she's tall too. I don't like her. I just don't like that bitch. I'm not jealous of her, but I do wish my stomach was flat. Oh, anyway, let me go back to this. Okay. I like this too, because this is how I picture me and my new boyfriend when he come over tomorrow. And we're going to leave the kids in the house by themselves, and we're going to find a beach. Well, it's kind of chilly, though. Well, I can make a beach. You know what? I can go to the bathtub and put some of that Calgon Take Me Away shit in the water. But I get it from Dollar Tree. You make the water blue. I'm going to put some blue food coloring in there. Because Easter coming up. The Dye of Easter Egg. I'm going to put some blue food coloring in there. I'm going to pretend it's a beach. And then I'm going to act like I'm Beyonce. I'm going to get a blonde wig. Like Donna be wearing them blonde wigs and shit. Them old cheap ass, raggedy ass wigs. And she talking about she going to show her hair after she get out the shower tomorrow. I doubt it. I highly doubt it. Talking about she going to have a towel on and show her hair how pretty it is when it's wet and it's curly and shit. I don't believe it. She's a liar. She's a fucking liar. And her pants on fire. The truth ain't there. She said she might do it tonight. But she said her husband don't like her doing that kind of shit too much. You know how I know? I heard it. Because I went over there and actually projected for a change in her shit in her house. And I got so jealous when I went over there. I just left. And I slammed the door real hard. And they said, what was that? And she said, that was number that damn bumzilla. He said, how you know? I said, because she said she smelled fish. And you know what? She was right. I have not washed my pussy in like over a month. Okay, and I'm on my period. Okay. This is right here. Hello, daddy, daddy. You know, men like when you call him daddy. I'm calling my man daddy, daddy. I used to hear Donna say that all the time, daddy, daddy. But I'm going to call my man from Plenty of Fish, daddy, daddy. What y'all think? You think I should do that? I think I should call him daddy, daddy. Yeah. I'm going to call him Daddy Daddy. Yeah, but I'm going to play this one to get us. I'm just trying to set the pace real quick, okay? Because something ain't going wrong. Something ain't my equipment. Okay. I want to plug on this real quick because I like her and it gets me in the mood and I get to thinking I'm real sexy. Okay, the commercial on, you know, the new thing we do now when the commercial come on. Yeah, rah, rah, rah. Whose team we on? Bumzilla. Bumzilla. Go, Bumzilla. I used to be a cheerleader, y'all. I used to stand in a V formation. I'd be at the very top. But the girls didn't want to hold me because I smelled like ass and fish. I like this. It is how I feel. You don't want to come on. Oh, I know. I got to put it right there. There we go. I say come on now. My spirits command you to come on now. There we go. Oh, come on now. Y'all can't keep on sending these notifications through. I've been drinking. I get filthy when that liquor get into me. I've been thinking. Why I smell so stinking, daddy? I stink, daddy. I don't know why I won't wash my pussy. I smell like fish, daddy. I need a bath or a shower. I need to stay up in there in a fucking hour or more. Whatever. Until you call me your filthy, slutty whore, I want you, daddy. Eyes off my no fatty, I want you, daddy. Drunken love, want you. I woke up in the kitchen because Donna astrally projected over my ass. And whooped my ass and blacked my eyes. And then she choked me. And next thing I remember is she putting me up against the wall with one hand. And she whispered in my ear and said, bitch, you better show your face the next morning. And I hate her. I hate her. Damn, why everything gotta be about Don? I'm supposed to be singing about my sugar daddy coming over here. I hope he got money too, y'all. Guess where he work? He work at 31 Flavor. It's an ice cream parlor like that. He's only 16, though. I like him, though. 5-7-11. Hey, no. He work at 7-Eleven. See, I'm a big liar. And because Beyonce just said walking in her lot, 7-Eleven, which don't mean 7-Eleven, an inconvenience store. That's in numerology. And it has to do with the goddess, you know, of destruction, the 7-Eleven. So I can break it down for you. Donna thinks she knows some shit, but she don't know nothing. sounded really a very, 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 very gifted practitioner, but I act like I don't think she is, but I'm damn scared of that bitch. You see, I don't want to say shit about that hoe, because, you know, that bitch is she's a force to be reckoned with. She is a highly practicing witch. I'm telling you, that bitch is a high-ranking one at that. That hoe, shit. She tell me about them IY parties. She goes, she actually project herself there with her damn coat, overcoat on with nothing under it, and drop it, and me having sex with all, and orgies with all those people. I wish I could do that, but my belly too flabby, shit. Who am I fooling? Ain't no man coming up here to see me tomorrow, shit. I can't do no reading. Fuck it. I think the people, I'm looking at the screen. Ain't nobody in here but me anyway. Fuck it. Let's let me go. I'm gonna cry myself to sleep, but I'm gonna get drunk first. Simple myself. If I do say so myself. Jay-Z, I like them East Coast men accent. I love those East Coast men accent. This is far. It hurt. We don't accept this bird. Ain't got time to take your drawers off. Out. I'm nice. Turn it. Okay. Cake, may not eat the cake, anime. I love to eat a whole cake, that's why I'm getting so fucking fat. I'm just talking, you know what, these people, I'm gonna see if anybody else come in the room. Until they come back in the room, and then I done got out of doing that damn reading for Capricorn. It's like the people don't wanna be fucking with me no more. I bought all those subs for nothing. I bought all them damn subs for nothing. And don't nobody want to fuck with me. They don't even fuck with me. Ain't that fucked up when people stop fucking with you? That's really fucked up, isn't it? That's real fucked up when they don't want to fuck with you no more, right? That's real fucked up when the crowd don't fuck with you no more. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I can't wait for this young man to come over. He only 16. I met him off Plenty of Fish, though. But I hope he don't tell his mother, though, because, you know, that's what I do. I turn out young men. Because the older ones my age like me. I don't appeal to them. Because they say, you got to be older than 41. You look like you're 91. And I just say, no, I'm 41. And I just don't have no, you know. I just don't get no good luck with the young guys. They just don't like me for some odd reason. You know what I think it is? I think that damn Donna put a damn spell on me that my beauty don't come through like it should. My beauty is not coming through like it should. And that damn spell, she put a spell on my ass, and I don't like that. I really don't like that. But you know, when I get depressed, I like to listen to music like this. It makes me feel so pretty, and it just makes me feel like okay, it's a commercial. Well, I don't got to do the Team Bumzilla thing I started today. That's my new thing for the new year. Somebody just came in and went right back out. Damn, I ain't got no crowd, nobody to watch my dramatic ass shit. What the fuck? Well, I don't care. I'm going to sit here, and if I don't get a crowd, at least of three in here. In my mom, I don't know, where's Zuri been? Maybe the curse took her out quicker. I don't know. But I'm going to listen to this song and encourage myself. You know, sometimes you just got to pick yourself up when you don't feel good and brush yourself off and encourage yourself. If don't nobody else tell you you're beautiful and you got bitches like Donna calling you a lemon frog face bitch and everybody calling you names, you listen to music like this and it reminds you. See, right now he's singing to me. He's singing to me. I ain't forgot that I owe somebody some money. You'll be surprised the trouble I'm having with that damn PayPal. You know who I'm talking to, if they hear it. And if you hear it, tell them what I said. I ain't forgot, Daddy. I'm going to give them that money. It's something, it did it before. It used to do it before when I was a regular donor or somebody. I used to do that before. Anybody want to send me some money? If anybody hear me, please do. I can use it. I love this. This is Al Green, Simply Beautiful, and Maxwell did his rendition at the BET Awards that time and tore that shit up. And I love Simply Beautiful because I am simply beautiful. My new name is Rain. Do not refer to me no more as Bumzilla. I am Rain Bumzilla, High Priestess Whore. Nobody coming in the room? Why won't nobody come in the room? Won't nobody come in the room? Won't nobody... I guess they don't want any readings. I guess Donna done talked them out. They really believe what that old bitch been saying. Man, I don't have a boyfriend. I lied about that. I got a free trial on Plenty of Fish. I lied about Donna's husband leaving her. I saw a vision. They over there just kissing and hugging and loving on each other. And I see him licking her legs and her thighs and everything. And she older than me, and she get more dick than I get. And that's a damn shame. And I'm 41. Who am I fooling? Shit, I hope to live as long as she do and pussy still get wet like hers. Shit. For real. Well, I'm gonna listen to this and then I'm giving them a little more chance to get in this room if they want to read. I can make up something. I can stir something together. I was gonna show them how I told him a lie. See, I was gonna make some witchy. Well, I did make some beef stew, but I was gonna act like I was just making it. Oh, really? Oh, okay. I just got a text. I think I need to unwind this up for real. I just got a text, y'all. I gotta go for real, y'all. Even though anybody in the room. Just know what this song is singing about. That's what I'm about to do. Go do wrong. Yeah. In the morning, honey. Ain't nothing open that late but legs and motel rooms, baby. That's what mama used to say. How she can make it. Ooh. If there's a time, homeboy, you don't break that board. I gotta get off this bitch because he just texted me, y'all. Bye, y'all.